What's up, guys? Welcome back into Patty G Films Food Review. Today, we're reviewing Super Mario's Salvadorian food truck.
I'm not gonna pretend like I haven't been here 42 times, but
I've already been here quite a few times too, but in all actuality, I'm gonna be there many more times.
Yeah, because like the thing is that like we got in a fat workout this morning, so we're definitely our hunger senses are definitely heightened. Every time I go to the food truck, I always get the veggie burrito because it's so bomb. And like one thing about Salvadorian food is that I've found the burritos, they like press them like this, so they got that nice like golden texture.
Good seal going too.
Yeah. It does really seal it off. And also, the vegetables that they have in here are so much different than like Mexican and stuff.
Right.
They got carrots, zucchini.
Broccoli,
yeah.
Oh, as for me, I've got this torta, asada torta. My sincerest apologies to any of our Hispanic viewers in the community. My Spanish pronunciation is just not really there. I speak Asian languages and I speak English. I do not speak anything else.
I mean, dude, at least not torta or a quesadilla.
Yeah, at least I'm not going that bad. I'm making an effort for you. There's not a lot I can say about this time, not gonna lie. I'm not very well versed in Latin American culture as much as I am Asian cultures.
When my family and I used to go to Mexico, we'd see these Americans and they would talk to the employees of the resort and they would say in English, and then they'd be like, the employees would be like, I don't speak English, and then they would just say it louder. As if that way they're gonna fucking
ethnocentrism.
I know. And one of the staples of Hispanic cuisine is definitely jarrito.
Jarritos, the official national soft drink of Mexico.
That's how you know it's good when someone does that.
Occasionally you just need that carbonation, bro.
I gotta admit, LaCroix is definitely my shit.
Fort Lauderdale slut water.
But every once in a while, I do like to indulge in a good jarrito. All right, so first impressions, what we got in terms of cleanliness, last
very meshy compared to the last time.
Okay, yeah. I would say compared to the wrap I got,
this drips juice. Like compared to the falafel, this is like falling out, man. I could take like a pita and scoop this up afterward or something, but it's not the way to do it. What I'm gonna do next, salsa verde, my friend. With that green shit.
Also, shout out to Kim behind the camera. He doesn't like to be on camera, so
he's, Kimbo Slice.
Yeah, he's making it happen. He's making it happen in post. Thanks. Shout out, Kim.
Yo.
Every time I go to take a bite, it like drips on my fucking head.
Do you think there's a different fashion in which you would have / should have ordered it? Or is the bread, does the bread bring it all together for you?
The bread brings it all together, man.
This is so fucking good. Oh my god.
This is good, it's just fucking getting all over me. I'm kind of a messy eater to begin with too, so this is not incredibly fun for me.
This isn't something you'd want to eat on a date. Mm-mm. I don't know if I'd go on a falafel date, dude. I gotta be honest.
Nor would I.
It's smelly, dude. Think about, what if like,
With garlic, I would not make out with somebody after I eat it.
Anything with garlic, and then you go back, and you get in the bedroom, and you're fooling around, and like, there's that undertone of garlic.
Mm-hmm.
Can't fuck with it, dude. What's your favorite Hispanic cuisine? What are your favorite Hispanic dishes?
Oh man, that's such a hard question to ask me, but I like Peruvian sandwich. I like Salvadorian torta.
What do you think of this pastry right here? Do you think this is a pretty Americanized thing?
I'd say so. If there's any Hispanic viewers willing to chime in, we want your comments in the section below. Would you call a turnover a Salvadorian dish or just some westernized bullshit?
We talked about this last food review. If you go to Casa Que Pasa expecting to get a really authentic experience, dude, it's just awful. My dad told me that cheddar cheese is pretty Americanized.
Mm-hmm.
It's mostly like that white cheese.
They don't have access to cheddar down there. They use cotija.
What do you mean access? How do you get access to cheddar?
Be close enough to America. Cheddar is a very American staple, in my opinion.
Do you know anything about how they make it, or like?
Well, I know that they use rennet in cheddar, whereas I think that's a different enzyme to coagulate the milk proteins in cotija. Cotija is a lot saltier.
Oh, and they can't do it in other countries. They just don't want to.
They just, well, It's, I think it's a mix of both.
All right, let's bust open this freaking whatever this is, a turnover, man.
What kind of, did you get again?
I got the raspberry or the whatever.
That one's good. I like the one with the, it's like a whipped cream or some kind of filling.
Yeah. I kind of wish the whole thing didn't have filling. Like when I get to the part with the filling, I get a little bit sad, but you know.
I'm not gonna lie, the creamy filling part appeals to my breeding kink.
Wait.
What?
Oh my god, it's so flaky. Mm-hmm. So playful. What's the cream? What's the base of that cream?
Just. You ever had like a cream cheese Danish?
Yeah.
A lot like that.
There's a lot of pluses to reviewing Super Mario's, dude. Mm-hmm. 40 feet from the Syrian Trap House. Reasonably economical. I'd say $8.50 for this, man. My god, I'm down.
Same rate as the falafel truck, basically.
Yeah. And I would say quality is about the same, like just as authentic.
Just with a different nationality.
Yeah, of course. Is this a food truck that you'd consider bringing a girl to for a date?
Yes and no.
Like, maybe you wouldn't get this, but is there something in mind that's less messy that you might get?
I'm gonna sound very white for saying this, but I think the quesadilla is the least messy thing they serve.
You didn't? That is very white of you to say. When I was little and I used to eat cheese, I would always make quesadillas, dude, like 4 times a day, any chance I got. So yeah, quesadillas slap hard. Mm-hmm. And when you add in the little things, whether it be beans or if you're a chicken eater, you add in some chicken or steak or something.
Some hot sauce.
Yeah.
That was me growing up. I always had to have it kind of spicy.
You said that you forgot your special hot sauce. And then you said that you didn't want to bring it because the Hispanic viewers might be a little offended.
Trader Joe's makes something called a yuzu habanero kind of hot sauce. And yuzu is a Japanese citrus that's a kind of a cross between a grapefruit, a lemon, and an orange.
I don't know what would have happened to you if you would have.
It probably would have.
They might have come after you, dude.
They might have. I don't know. Well, let's not say that about our Hispanic community, though, because we're not going to inherently assume they're violent people.
No, and I don't know. And it's like, I think if you would have used that on the last episode, I think that group of people would have come after you too. It's, you know, it's just...
Yeah, I would have gotten canceled.
Yeah.
I would have canceled you too in the process.
in association. So what do we think? Cafe Roomba next?
Cafe Roomba next, for sure. For the viewers that don't know what Cafe Roomba is, it's a Peruvian sanguichera, or... Okay, cut. I fucking butchered that.
No, I got it.
Sanguicheria, I think. I don't know how to fucking pronounce it. Once again, I speak Asian language.
I remember when I was there, I think it's sanguche. It's like it's S-A-S-A-N-G-U-C-H-E. So I think it's sanguche, maybe. I don't know though. Guys, Patty G Films food review. Super Mario Salvadorian food truck. 1, 2, 3, we're out.